Yes, it's the same jumper I've worn for like the last few episodes. At least I think I have. Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure I have. It's cold up here in Sweden. In real life, it's cold in the apartment because I can't afford heating. I can, I'm just tight. Not tight, just careful. That's what my dad used to say. Poor Abby, she's like an ice block now. But she'll get over it. She'll learn to love the cold. Just extra layers. I've got a bit sidetracked now. Mainly because the game's going so well. There's not really more much to tell you. It's going to be a very, very interesting season should we get promoted. And at the moment, we are on course. I love it here in Landvetter. I don't want to leave. At least not until like the Champions League comes calling. But can Sweden qualify for the Champions League? I think they can. So maybe, just maybe. Anyway, hello everyone. Welcome to another episode of TYC. I am your host with the most. Such a basic bitch joke. And yes, we are on fire. We are still top, but we have lost a game. We lost a game. That was to Advidaburgs, which I think is a great Advidasane. It's not even the same language, Mike. Don't even try it. And as you can tell, they're very difficult to beat. Two wins, one defeat, nine draws. Nine draws in 12 games. Unbelievable. I mean, it's a long undefeated run because they lost the first game of the season, so they've gone 11 games unbeaten. Incredible. From our point of view, though, that is the only game that we have dropped points in. Other than that, we've won every single game. We beat Berger 4-0. It was very tasty. A tasty affair. See what I did there. Then we lost to Advidaburgs, Advidasane. Then we lost to Young. Sorry, we beat Jungskile and then beat Nico Pings 5-2. They got two goals, which was very irritating, but they're a pretty decent side. Today we're taking on Carlslunds IF and then Vänersborgs. Now, Vänersborg or Vänerborg. Yeah, is it Vänersborgs? Yeah, there's always an S in the middle. We're taking Vänersborgs on, and they're currently sat in fourth, 10 points behind us. And Carlslunds are down in 14th. So, realistically, we should be looking to win at least one of these games. Obviously, the first one is the one I'm looking at. The second one, I can understand it. And we have a little bit of a bad news, which is that Elias Ziani is suspended for today. But fortunately, I get to bring in Mark Bosnich's kid, Emir Bosnich. He's not really Mark Bosnich's kid. And if you remember Mark Bosnich, well done you. Hussein is being a pain in the ass. I've just said, yes, you can go because we don't really need you anymore. I'm very loyal to my players. He was excellent last season. Now I'm shipping him out. I feel like a real dick. But there can be no room for sentimentality in this save, or in any save with me, because if you annoy me once, that's enough. Right, so just carry on where you left off, guys. I've not even gone through the lineup. I mean, you should all know them by now. Household names, all of them. You only remember Rutaskull, don't you? But if you are interested in the team that is out, it is da-da-da, here. Hansen's in goal. He's in goal. Bosnich, Usyk, Worm, Slot. Gorgos, Pearson, Arstead, I'm going to call him Pearson, and Furhan Abic, who has been excellent. Elio Turcan's had a very good turn of form as well, and Sad Handel on the right. I love his name. With Rutaskild leading the line. He is now on 16 goals from 12 games. Top notch, top notch. Right, off we go. 2 minutes in. Can't believe there's not been a highlight. We're slacking. My recent gym work is still hurting, so that shows how unfit I am. Well, hello. We've cleared the ball here from a set piece, and it was a really poor ball out by Turkan. One thing I will say is, even though we scored five goals in the last game, we've not played as well. Like, you can tell that defeat against Advidasane, or whatever their name is, it did knock us quite a lot, and we've given away a penalty in the first 10 minutes to make your life a lot harder. Nordenberg sent Mbop the wrong way. Not the start I had planned, I won't lie. For all the fact that we've lost two games, we're actually not that far ahead. If we lose this, which we currently are, and Falkenbergs win their game, suddenly they're only 4 points behind, which is nothing in the relative scheme of things, because we're just not playing very well here. It's 37 minutes have gone. There's not been another highlight, and we're just chasing shadows here. Normally, we've got a really good habit of sort of bouncing back when we do go behind, but I've not seen anything in this game to suggest that that's going to be on the cards here. as Olsen whips in a good ball to the back post, and Bermudez heads it over. Really, really poor. Like, really poor. This is a really bad half of football from us. Like, we've not got any of the front three in. I haven't seen him touch the ball. Don't. Bop. Dear. Dear. Dear can't save a cross now. Oh no, you're shit. No, no. Yeah, Lipo Vac there on the rebound from the woeful goalkeeping. We've had 3 shots, they've had 12. That is one of the worst halves. I'm telling them, you've been awful. You've been absolutely awful so far. Sort your lives out. I have no idea where that's come from. This is ridiculous. They're absolutely pumping us here. So it's not even close. We still only have, what is it, 4 shots and one of them on target. It's so unlike us. Rudiskjold, though, gets his 17th goal of the season out of absolutely nothing. A good ball in by Slot. And it's 2-1, completely against the run of play. Good, but geez. Not what I was expecting when I started up the game today. Yeah, I've gotten so used to winning with Landvetter. It's a bit odd when it's not happening. And then I don't really know what to do, because I've never really needed to worry about it. For God's, it's so easy. For all the good play Slot just did there, he's just let that bloke put a cross in. Bosnick's going to have to come off. Rundqvist is going to come on for his first appearance for the club. This has been an absolutely atrocious day. Robert's going to come on for Sad Handle as well. Really, really not impressed here. This is exactly what I was hoping wouldn't happen. I really don't want to bottle it from here. I mean, technically it's not bottling, because we are, well, I mean, you can tell I'm trying to make it up, can't you? But Rudiskjold, that's going over the bar for a corner. We're not meant to be anywhere near the top, but when you're there, I expect better. I can't. I'm shocked. I'm genuinely stunned. There's been barely any highlights. We've not done anything. Really, the goal came against the run of play. That is a pathetic attempt, and I'm far from pleased. And I've told the boys I'm fuming at that. Someone's going to get dropped after that, because that is unacceptable. They're in the relegation zone, for Christ's sake. And that's our third loss of the season. I mean, don't get me wrong, 3 losses in 13 games, and you've won the other 10. It ain't bad, but it's happening a little more consistently than I would like, is probably the way I can put it. Bosnick, I mean, Ziani, it can't possibly be that I need to have him in the team, and without him we're terrible. And 2 defeats could rapidly, sorry, a defeat could rapidly become 2, and if you suddenly do that, it could, you know, you're talking about a bit of a slump, and that ain't good. I just want to say thank you for all the kind words as well about how much you guys are enjoying the series, and you're saying it's a really good journeyman, thank you. I am thinking about releasing a video with my thoughts on FM23, because they are a little bit controversial this year. I know quite a lot of people have said the sort of same thing about it, but I'm not sure. I mean, the thing I'm enjoying about this is that I'm being quite good at the save. This save wasn't going well. I can't say I'd be playing a lot of FM. Do you know what I mean? I've got about like 20 saves that I've just kept starting, but I just can't get into one. Do you know what I mean? I'm finding it really hard just to get into a save. This is the only save really that I've kind of gotten into, apart from a Bournemouth bottom at Christmas one where I got them into the Champions League the year after. Don't ask how I did it. Yeah. Okay, so Ahmed Hussein has now gone to NAFT at Maysan, so hopefully that'll make people a little bit more at ease. But I don't know. I'm going to go with the same team, because I don't really see the need to change. You know, these are the guys that have got us to where we are. It only feels fair that they kind of dig us out of the hole and give themselves a chance to, you know, redeem themselves after that last game, because it was very poor. I'm going to say to them, I expect to see a much better performance from you today. Have my hands in my pockets as well, so they know I mean business. We've already made a better start. We've had nearly as many shots in this opening 20 minutes as we had in the whole of the first half of the last game. But still, no highlights. Why is that I can only see one of their roles? I can only see the role that they got one ball-winning midfielder. That was a bit risky. Rizaskill, good header there to Arthur Abic. Sad Handle into Elio Turkan. That would be some header, Elio, if you were to score from there, mate. And funnily enough, he hasn't. It'd be nice just to kind of get back to keeping some clean sheets, really, because that's a lot of what our full form was built on. Not a good half again. I'll just say, we're getting shots away, keep going. I don't want to be too hard on them, because I think confidence is a little fragile at the moment. If I keep having a go at them about my expectations, it's only going to get worse. So I've got to be a bit more positive. That's a great ball over to Ruta Skjold. I think he's ruined the chance. Yeah, so it was a really poor touch that took him away from goal. Not what I expect from the league's top goal scorer, that's for sure. But this is a much better start to the second half. We're already having much more in the way of highlights, which is a good start. That's not a great ball, though, by Pearson, I have to say. Win that. There you go. We do look a lot better with Ziani in there, I have to say. I think he kind of does add a little bit of a different dimension, especially down that left-hand side. There's Elio Turkan. Go on, just pass it in, lad. Get in, Elio Turkan. That's his fifth goal of the season, and that's a really good return. It's something that I've needed to do this year, because last year, obviously, we had Hussein and we had Anderson, and both of them were kind of contributing with the goals, and there weren't a lot coming from anywhere else, unless it was Wallin from the penalty spot. This is a lot better. If I can get these wing forwards getting a few more goals, then that's going to help contribute towards it. I have to say, Sad Handel has been good, but I think Turkan's been a real find, even though Sad Handel's actually rated better than him. I personally think Turkan's been a lot better. Ruta Skjold's in around the back here, and he's hit it straight at the goalkeeper. I don't care if we win this 1-0, 2-1, 2-0, whatever, just get the win. 5 minutes to go, and I need this as a bounce back. It's a brilliant ball by the goalkeeper to Lacasso. Does paintings, doesn't he? See what I did there. Oh, God's sake. They bet it's going to be 1-1. Oh, he's missed! Just can you please get a second and put this to bed, lads? That would be brilliant. Great ball by Pearson. Anderson. It didn't need to be that hard. That's a really poor ball out. Slot into the mixer. Sad Handel. Oh! Would have been a wonder goal. Would have been an amazing finish from Sad Handel had that not gone in. We just about deserve the win. We scraped it. 1-0. We're out of form. Well, I say we're out of form. We're not playing as well as we were, that's for sure. But sevens all across the board at the back. Idrissi coming on. I think I might give Usyk a rest. I think he's really struggling a little bit. But Persson and Abic in the middle dictated play. Turkan got the goal. Not great from Ruta Skjold or Anderson. But yeah, okay, we got the win. And that's all I care about. That's all I care about. And would you believe it? El Idrissi wants to play more games. You can get that, mate. Usyk is going to take a little bit of a break. And I think I'm going to bring him in. In terms of where we come back, really, I don't want it to be too long. Because I think I definitely want to play the game against Falkenbergs. Because obviously they're spiders in the league. So let's come back for Falkenbergs and Tvakars. I think that's how you say it. Vakas? Tvakars? I have no idea how you say it. Either way, though, let's come out for those two. So I'm only going to have two games in between before we play them in July. So that'd be good. Just realised that because this is now sort of in June, it's weird because then my intro doesn't make any sense because I was like, oh, it's cold in Sweden and it's in December. And it's not. It's in June. Good consistency, Mike. Well done, mate. But on that note then, everyone, I wanted to say thank you very, very much for watching. I hope that this has been a good episode. A bit shorter. It felt very, very quick, actually. The highlights, there weren't many of them. So if it's a little on the short side, I'm sorry about that. But hopefully we'll have a big title clash against Falkenbergs next time out. Until I see you there, make sure that you like, share, and subscribe. Obviously, drop one on the video. If not, drop a like. Don't drop... Yeah, start again. Please drop a like on the video. Share and subscribe if you've enjoyed it. And of course, make sure you come back for the next episode. Until I see you then, take care of yourselves, everyone. Stay cool. I used to be able to say it in my sleep, and recently I've just been buggering up, and I don't know why. Idiot.